Are they ready?
Yeah.
Because you know
it's short. Okay. Before.
Did I throw my mask?
If you could redo high school, what would you do differently?
I would start living in the moment, not worrying about what everyone else is doing around me.
I'd probably not care so much what people think and just have fun. Don't stress about the little things because it just goes by fast. Like, it's literally pretty much already over. It's weird.
I honestly would redo absolutely nothing from my high school experience except for the fact that I dress like a bum.
Just go for it. No one cares. No one's going to judge you.
Well, I would definitely talk to people my freshman year because I didn't end up making friends until sophomore year and it was just awkward.
I would definitely not. I think get so overwhelmed by Fillies in school.
4 years really flies by so fast. So I would just take time to enjoy my friends, high school, and where I'm at because I'll never get this opportunity again.
Not care about what people think of me when I'm being completely myself. And make my own decisions and not let other people's opinions influence me.
I would start Fillies sooner.
Wait, I need to put it in words.
It's like having confidence in who I am as a person.
Just being more open to different people and different experiences because I think in my junior and senior year, I did that much more. And if I would have done it sooner, I would have made a lot more like friendships and done more cool things.
Focus a little bit more on my grades, but
I feel like I would tell myself not to be so like shy.
What's your best Miss Lewis impression?
Y'all, do it again. One more time.
I see one more memory mistake. We're pulling this out. We're not performing at the game.
Hook up, we're kicking.
Y'all pull in. Give me some positives.
Guys, I have this talk every year. Whenever you go home and tell your parents that Miss Lewis was mean to you today, as a parent, I know that whenever my Savvy comes home from school and she tells me a girl was mean to her in the bathroom, I imagine her getting punched up to a wall and bullied. But in reality, she really just said something mean. So I don't want to hear your parents complaining to me that I'm being too rude to y'all.
It's no big deal, yeah. It's no big deal.
Is she gonna see this?
If you and your parents have problems with the way we're running things, you need to come to me. Not IHELP, not the APs. Me. I have Fillies on the team who are spreading rumors about the way we're doing things, and that is not acceptable.
She always does that!
And I need y'all to go home and tell her exactly what I said and don't skew my words. Does anyone have any more excuses or want to share anything else with the team? I better not hear any more of that this year.
As of right now, what's your top college choice?
Okay, so I have two. My first one is University of Southern California. Sorry, Mom. My second one is Chapman University.
Where are you going now?
UCLA.
I don't have a top college. I really don't. Like, Arizona, LSU, UT, but I can't get into UT, so, like, that's an issue.
Well, here's the thing.
I'm not 100% sure, but as of right now, I'm going to Texas State.
UT Austin, TCU, OU, and Florida State. I'm going to OU, Boomer Sooner.
Versus A&M. But I'm going to Blinn.
I'm going to A&M, Giggum.
A&M or UT?
A&M. I really like OU and I like San Diego State. I'm going to San Diego. I can't believe I was going to OU.
I'm actually already accepted to Tech. I am going to Tech. I'm going to nursing school.
A&M or Texas State.
I'm going to Blinn College Station.
Probably Texas A&M.
University of Arkansas.
If you could tell your freshman self anything, what would it be?
If I could tell my freshman self something, it would probably be to stop overthinking everything because no one's paying as much attention as you think that they are.
Gosh, I don't even know her.
I would tell my freshman self to start dyeing your eyebrows because it makes your forehead look so much smaller.
Really just like appreciate the little things and not take things for granted.
Freshman year was really good. Honestly, like, I was thriving.
His Tiger Stripe highlights were not it.
Oof. I would also tell myself, like, make relationships with people, even if you wouldn't expect it, because I would never expect to be as close with the senior Fillies as I am now, and I love it, and I know, like, we're gonna stay in touch for a long time.
What's the best piece of advice you've ever been given?
My mom always tells me to always understand the other side of the story before you snap back at someone.
Like, no matter how stressed that I get, to always just like put God first and to just live for Him.
Maybe don't be so insecure.
Just making sure that you're always appreciating people for like their strengths and what they can contribute. Making sure that everyone always feels appreciated, because that's going to make sure that you all like reach your goal together and as a group and not as individuals.
If you're put in any situation, like, make sure it's a positive one so you're able to look back on it and it can just be something happy.
What's been the hardest thing about high school?
Probably like managing my time.
For sure junior year. It's accepting the fact that everyone's changing, it's a crazy time for everyone, and you just kind of have to go with the flow.
I don't know, realizing that your self-care is more important than your friendships and like hurting other people's feelings. As selfish as it sounds, you need to like do what's best for you, because you're working towards your future and you shouldn't want anyone to hold you back.
Just putting myself out there and not caring about what other people think.
What do you want to have accomplished before you graduate?
I want to get matching tattoos with my mom and my sister, and possibly get a nose piercing.
Have you done any of those?
None of them. I'm not 18 yet, and the nose piercing is not happening.
Regrets. Just do what makes you happy, and don't stress out too much. I think I've done that. I was kind of stressed in the middle of the year, but now I've really like prioritized myself.
I need to get a job and apply to college. That's about it.
I have done both of those things. I am a babysitter and I pick up kids. And I mean, I applied to college, so.
Oh, I just want to know what I want to do.
So I want to work with kids with autism and Down syndrome and just help them.
Just making sure that I take all the opportunities I can get and make tons of more memories with my teammates and my friends, so that looking back, I won't have any regrets. Yes, I would say I've definitely done that. I think that I've been given a lot of opportunities this year, like time to just spend with friends, and Fillies has also just provided so many opportunities to prepare me for college, so I feel like I've really taken a hold of those and made the most of my year.
What's going to be the hardest goodbye?
Everyone on the team and all the relationships I made and our humor and our jokes. I'm just gonna miss like being able to come in and laugh.
All my friends and my family, of course. I'm just gonna miss this. My voice is shaking.
My dogs.
My team and just the atmosphere of Fillies, because even though like I'm trying out for dancing in college, like there's nothing that'll be the experience that Philly gives you.
My junior Philly girls, because I've just gotten really close with them this year and don't want to leave them.
Everyone, like leaving everyone. Because like I've been with the same people for 4, 3, 2, 1 years.
My family and just like everyone I'm around every day, like obviously all the Fillies and just all my school friends, because it's just so weird that we're all going to be like leaving each other.
The fact that I don't know, it's just really awkward.
All my senior girls and also the juniors, shout out to Front Triangle Jazz, because I love y'all and I am just going to miss seeing y'all's faces every day. Right in the morning, 6 a.m.
It's just like everyone that I love, you know, but I feel like it hasn't really hit me yet because I'm excited, so I haven't really like thought about it, but I mean, I'm gonna miss my family and friends.
Okay, that's good, right?
Seniors, just seniors in general, everyone, because we bonded and got super close.
I tried!
What are you gonna miss most about Fillies?
I'm gonna miss those small in-between moments. There's just so many experiences that like you can only really get on Fillies. Like all the trips were so fun.
It's having a group of people who like work so hard towards one thing.
Stop laughing.
I'm gonna miss the sisterhood part of Fillies and feeling like I always have people that are there for me and that I can trust.
All the friendships I've made on Fillies are like so good.
All the memories I've made with everybody and not getting to see all these girls every single day at 6 a.m. and our time together.
What are you gonna miss most about being home?
my dog and my friends and the comfort of my own bed.
Having Kendall like a few minutes away from me, so I'm gonna miss just having her really close.
It's running away from my mom trying to give me hugs every day I get home from school.
I think I'm gonna miss Kingwood just in general because I say that I want to leave here and get out of here, but I think whenever I do leave, like, I'm gonna miss the small town vibes.
Spending alone time with my parents because I've gotten so close to them and I love them so much.
I'm not gonna miss it.
Well, I'm gonna miss it, but I am home.
What are you looking forward to in college?
Just meeting new people, going somewhere different, getting out of Kingwood.
I'm just really excited.
I'm
gonna need a second.
The new opportunities and everything.
Getting to know how to do things on my own because I'm just very dependent on my parents, and it's gonna be a big change, but I'm excited for it.
Trying new things and being in a new atmosphere.
I'm just really excited for like a new start and to be out of Texas and experience other types of people.
What's your final message to the team?
My final message to the team would probably be to just enjoy everything. Even like the small moments whenever you're like really down, they can end up being like the best moments and like you won't even realize until you're done. So just have fun, work hard.
To obviously work hard and keep pushing and doing whatever you're supposed to be doing, but also have fun because sometimes the most fun moments on Phillies are whenever you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing.
You're gonna have to give me a sec.
So just take in every moment and just think about how all the goods outweigh the bads. Even if it's like a bad day or a bad performance, it's only making you stronger.
It'll go by fast, so just enjoy it.
To not take any moments for granted and to keep your eyes above all the waters. Waters, aka all the crazy stuff that life throws at us, because it's not worth putting your energy into things that don't make you happy. Sometimes you have to prioritize yourself over not good things.
Just never take anything for granted because these years go by super fast, and in the moment you might be like ready for college and ready to graduate and everything, but you're gonna look back and miss your time on the team, miss your time with all the girls and everything. So never take anything for granted.
The girls. When they say 4 years goes by so fast, it really does. In all the stress and everything you worry about for Phillies, like competition season, everything you're stressed about and working for, it all pays off in the end. And remember the end goal because that's what we're here for.
Just don't take things for granted and live in the moment.
Always trust the process, because I know like sometimes you hear like ideas or things we're doing and you're like, oh my gosh, and it just sounds crazy, but Miss Lewis and the officers seriously have the team's back and they are always going to advocate for you. So just trust in the process and I promise it'll turn out the way it's supposed to.
I'm starting this over.
Can we start over?
Like, I'm very dependent. Sorry. I'm...
This is literally losing my brain cells. Okay.
Check the yellow color.
Putting myself out there because, well, there's no because. Let me reset.
Megan, you need to turn the other way. I can see you out of the corner of my eyes.
Oh. Thumb holes or no thumb holes?
Can you delete that?
Yeah.
Because this is Africa.
I'm starting to just keep going.
Stop! Right, we were like not as close when we did this in the first part, so like I wouldn't laugh, but like now I can be like, can you turn away? Don't look at me.
Take a look at me then.
Stop!
Okay,
we would like to give a special shout out to our Stoclo moments every single morning.
We love our socials and all the talks we get.
I know you're gonna miss me eating my pasta salad every single morning.
I know you're gonna miss the tension after a bad practice.
I know you're gonna miss the donuts. I know you're gonna miss all those juice boxes. Those are so...
I know you're gonna miss the turf all over the floor.
I know you're gonna miss us really being productive and social.
I know you're gonna miss us leaving school every day to get Starbucks.
Or Chick-fil-A. I know you're gonna miss me dressing ugly every day and Sarah dressing cute every single day. I think that was good.
What do you want the rest of the team to take away from this senior class?
So this senior group is really special because they just kind of have each other's back. And not only do they have each other's back, but they have the team's back as well. And they have this loyalty towards each other and to the team that is, you just can't, it's irreplaceable. Like, you can't even compare it. Their ability to just love on everyone. I think that they're a very fun group who really puts the team first and the concept of family within our team first. They're very genuine and giving, and you can just, you can feel it. The rest of the team can feel it, I can feel it, and it just kind of sets the tone for the whole group. We're going to be a family, and we are going to get through anything together because we have each other.
What makes this group so special?
This group of seniors is a really hardworking but fun group that really just brings excitement to the team, and it's just nice to see the way that they interact with the underclassmen and the way that they continue to lead everyone, just in a fun and exciting way. So this group has kind of been through it all. You know, they started their freshman year with Harvey, and it was a very different year, and they really just stayed so positive through the whole thing. There was never any moment where I doubted if they were going to be committed or if they were going to come and give 100%. I never doubted that about this group. And they just have formed this personal connection, not only with me, but with everybody else. So I think I'm just going to miss that. I kind of truly feel like this senior group is like the glue that holds us together. And everything that life has thrown at them, they've been like, all right, like, what's next? Let's go. So I definitely think I'll miss that from this group.
What's your final message to the seniors?
I mean, I think I probably have a lot. I think my first would be to let them know how much I love them and adore them and want nothing but the best for them. That would be like the general one, I think, but the more important one, and I think the one that they need to hear, is how they just always need to be true to themselves and trust in God and continue following their heart and doing what's right. I mean, they're just such an amazing, special group that has always done that, I think, but just hearing it all the time and just always knowing their worth. I mean, I think you can go through stages of life where you forget that, or you let people make you believe differently, and I just hope that they always know how important, how special they are. They're just amazing, every single one of them, and they each individually have so much to offer this world, and I hope that they always follow their heart. I hope that they always come see me so I can see, you know, everything that they've accomplished and done, but just more importantly, I hope that they always know their worth and know how loved they are by everybody in their life.
To our seniors, I want to say on behalf of the team, thank you. Thank you for all the hard work and dedication y'all put in these past 4 years. You've been amazing role models for all of us. You guys have put your all into this team and have done nothing less than make it amazing for everyone.
Know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
10 months ago, I would have never thought I'd be able to call each and every one of y'all my best friends. Now I'm sitting here saying one of the hardest goodbyes I'll ever have to do. Y'all affected not only my life, but others around y'all more than you'll ever possibly know. Each one of you lights up a room the minute you walk in, and you will always know how to smile on anyone's face. I know the future holds great things for y'all, and I can't wait to see what you accomplish. I love you guys more than you'll ever know, and I'm so grateful I've had the opportunities to become so close to your class. Here's to the seniors.